Good evening, this Thursday evening, July 27, 2023. I think today is what a day. You see the fly action? Man, I cannot, cannot control myself right there. What a day, you see? A clean liquidity run right there. I mean, it's clean move, or according ICT term or concept, it's called low resistant liquidity run right there. So it start, I think, around PM section right there. So if anyone can identify the pattern, they're gonna win very big money today. Or simply you follow the DR model. I think Master, he didn't twist out that, he take the trade. It's a 1 minute time frame. But if you look at the 5 minute time frame, you can see that the DR model worked very well today, right? So basically you have a confirmation right here. It break down through the implied DR and also the DR low, then it come back to retest the midpoint right there, and you can short right there if you are well versed in the DR model. You can short them. You either short up here, or if you want, you can wait right here. It can give you the setup right here also, right? Right here you can see the auto block, fair value gap right there, and the retest right here. You see retest right there. That is the setup for you, and you see the huge move right here. So let's see what the move right here. Maybe for $6-$7 move. See that? $6.96 right here. So it's about $7 move right there. That's the absolute value. Let's see what is the standard deviation term. So basically you're gonna do from the EDR imply to the DR high. It's a giant right here. So basically 3.5 standard deviation move right there. That's the big standard deviation in the DR model that I see so far. 3.5, man. If you follow the DR model, you make huge money right here or there. Okay, the one thing I want to point out real quick before we go to a different subject. I mean, what I did today is amazing day. Right, here's the observation that we have before the market. Right, we saw the big drop to 12.94. The last time it stayed this low is 2020, January 2023. And then we see that the London high check out the prior day high, which is on Wednesday, right? And that means that the buy side liquidity rated either, liquidity graph, and it go down, or it's going to be market structure shift and it continue to go up. And then we continue to see, London high was rated, right? And then we have a question whether it's the continuous trend to go up or going to be a trend reversal. And in terms of weekly profile, we have in mind whether Wednesday low is the week low, because Wednesday was low. That means that today going to go up. It never touched the Wednesday low. So that's the weekly profile right there. So basically the weekly profile, you know, say that, you know, the high of the week and the low of the week is decided by Wednesday or Tuesday. That's an idea. And we have another idea, it's the second day player. Because yesterday is the high impact new release, right? Which is the FOMC decision to keep the interest rate unchanged. Oh, there's no high right there. So we wonder what the key level for it to show that it's gonna continue, the major level, for it to continue the trend, or it's gonna be reversal. And we did identify that in our analysis this morning. Okay, that's one of the things. And also the second thing I want to point out is that I did take the trade. We did take the trade. As soon as we finished the first hour recording at 10:30, right around here. I believe 10:30 right here. And I wait until what time right here? So it's 12:30, so another and half hour later. I keep watching, and then I saw the setup come beautifully. Even though this trade is trade again the trend, right? That this is the downtrend. So we anticipate on the so-called retracement of the downtrend into the key level. In this case, the key level is the DR mid level, and also is the sell side, the buy side liquidity right here. Okay. So basically, in the real time, when I took this trade, I saw the pattern, right? It's a lower low right here. That means the sell side liquidity ticking out. So my rule of engagement, our guru engagement, that we're gonna go long trade when we see the sell side liquidity taken, and it taken, and it make a lower low, okay? Right, and then we enter right here. That's our logic, and our target is around this error. Exactly, we just look at $1 move. That's our target profit, just $1 move, $1 for the trade and for 1 week. And we did reach our target right there, $1. We just try one share. That our, you know, rule right there. So even though this trade is again the overall trend, but it worked out because that move is guaranteed when and it play out well. However, if we want to do a short, then it will be a perfect short right here. Right? Why is a perfect short? Okay, look at the 5 minute timestamp. We know that the perfect short right there, because it's a DR model tell us that it's gonna be this gonna be a high of the day, right? Basically the DR model state that after 10:30 we know where is the high of day or lower day. After 10:30 we have a confirmation at this 10:55. It closed below the DR low and the IDR low, then it tells us this is gonna be the high of the day. And when we know that fact, then we know that this is just a trap to set up, to build up the liquidity before it going down. So then the make level is the confluent error for us right there, so we can show. So that is the short bar based on the DR model, right? That's the DR model. However, we remember in this morning when we identified this range right here, we said that we're going to engage when it broke down this range, and it did broke down it, that range, you know. So break out that range in the outside, and then it retest that range. So that's another confluent for us to go short right there. And another signal for it to go short is right here. It make a lower low, I mean a higher low. Yeah, so basically it keep everyone going here and go long, right? We did go long, but we are, we exit when it reached deep level perfectly. And when it reached deep level, it going down very heavily right there. So if we don't set our target right in this rate, we are gonna be in trouble right there. So for this short trade, if we are mixed right here, we can also have a nice entry entrance right here also at 13:10, which is 1:10 p.m. Eastern time right there. And it matches well with the on 1 minute time frame on ICT concept right here. All right, so basically you have, this is a bearish breaker, right? It's the swing low right there, right? And then you have a huge what, huge displacement and failure gap right there, and it retests on this bearish breaker right there, right? Bearish breaker, and it going down. Our intermediate target is right here, this range right here. And this range is a 1 hour failure gap right there. Let's look at the 1 hour. Where is our 1 hour time frame right here? So this is our intermediate level right here. I mean the first target, right? Because we see the half failure right here, and here's the bullish breaker. So when it go down, it's gonna retest the level, and it did. You see it around that level, and it come up again, and it go down real hard right there. So our second target gonna be this one, this auto block. You see this auto block right here, come down, retested auto block. And also another confluent error right here is the new week opening gap for this week right there. So if, you know, we identify this level, then we will confident go in here short right here also. That's amazing move, you see, very accurate algorithm right there. And it's eventually it take out the bicep liquidity of this one. Man, that's a huge move. Let's look at, oh, okay, I see. Yep. No, it not take out liquidity of that one yet, you see. And so let's see. This could be a what? This could be a signal of bullish right here, right? Maybe tomorrow it will go up, because it's maybe tomorrow come up here, right? Maybe tomorrow it will go up here at the level right here, right? And then go down, take our liquidity. So that's one of scenario right there for tomorrow. But anyway, we're not gonna take any trade for tomorrow. We only do one trade per week, and we did take one trade today, and it's it hit our target. That's the wonderful force right there. Okay, so that's if we go with this short trail right here, that will be our target. Target one, and then target two will be down here. Right, target two is down here. Target one, target two. Wow, what a move right there. Well, we haven't seen this move for a while. Because it built up so much liquidity right there, so it's run down. It grabbed a huge liquidity, so I think the smart money really make a lot of money over here. So this will be our study right there. Beautiful one right there. You see, this is a swing right here, and then you have another swing, bring it down, and then it retests at the original swing. This swing very important from the open at 9:30 to 10:30. This range tell you that you're gonna retracement to half of that range, and then it will be going down. One more thing that I want to point out, that I may have to go back to the ICT video. I think it's one of the guy point out that it's gonna be on core content month 5. He's talking about the four standardization. So I will do research more on that. So basically, the idea right here that it make a lower low right here, right? Let me see. So basically, it make a lower low right here, right? Lower low, and then it make a intermediate term high, and then it make a high or low right here. Then we project this lower low and intermittent low to the downside, and then it will move to, it will be in four standard deviation right there, basically right here. That is, yeah, it move. It reached four standard deviation. You see that? So that's an idea. Okay, so let's do see some trade that we check the trade. So basically, the trade we took today, I did do the swing shot right here. So we did log into our database. We take this trade, like we'll only take trade, and the setup name basically is the auto block fiber gap retest, and also called double bottom, and it's a long setup. And we, let me see. So here's our real time. We take a screenshot right there, right? So in the real time, you see right there. So this is auto block, and you see fibonacci graph and intermediate, term high right here, and it go down and it retests one and retest twice. And we go when it retest twice. And when we enter the trade, it did pull back a little bit right there on the 1 minute time frame, but on the 5 minute time frame, it looked perfect entry right there for us. But look at the 5 minute time frame. So it's perfect. You see, right, that perfect entry verse. Yeah, so we there and our target is $1 move, which is exactly around buy side liquidity of this you know range, and also it fit into the DR model, the mixed range right there. So it's everything is worked out perfectly right there. And our entry time we did record. So it's 11:56 on the M1 time frame and 11:55, which is perfect, you know, time of interest for us right there. And the reason we take the trade because we do, you know, second day play strategy. We see the buy side that we're taken out and the retracement took place, and now we want to see if the retracement is a temporary, you know, retracement or pull back or it's a reversal. And we take a long position as soon as we see the auto block retest, the block setup form on both M1. And the comment right here, so at 12:15, we move the stop loss to break even below the fair value gap, basically right here. So when we enter a trade, and we see the retracement here at 15 right here, right? If you're a little bit trade driven, I move the stop loss to break even right there. So it's going to be break even trade, but it's just a temporary break and go all the way, hit our targets perfectly at 12:30. Yep. So it's a clean move. So basically right there, you can see it's auto block. Follow up, retest one, retest twice, we're going. That's our setup right there. Okay, and then I do two more, you know, document the trade. We don't take it, but it's just a little document right here. So it's we did mention about that right here. Let's take a look. Right, so that's the note, the annotation about right there, right? So it's auto block. Do you see the auto block right here, right? Auto block, fair value gap right here, and a retest right there. And we know from the DR model it's gonna be bearish, so this is very high, you know, quality setup right there. We test the time entry at 4 o'clock, and our target gonna be at that moment we can only identify the target at a fair value graph on the 1 hour time frame, and later on when it's progress, when you know progress, when the trade, you know, progress layout, we see that another second target will be very deep down there on the auto block on I think last Wednesday. I did show before, I think it's right here. Let's look at the 1 hour, so right here you see we identified this. That's a second target, and also a new week opening up. The first, when we identify right here, the first target is second target. So if we want to scale out, it's the first target and second target right there. So that's the trade that, you know, with annotation right there. There's a 1 minute time frame. Let's take a look on the 5 minute time frame. Yeah, this is a 5 minute time frame. So basically it a confluent right here, it retests the DR model midpoint level right here. But you see the auto block right here, very tiny right there, and the failure gap very tiny. You have to look very carefully, you know, to see that. and you see the pullback is almost, you know, up there on the five level up. So if you have a tight stop, you may kick out. So you have to leave enough room for your stop loss so you can stay in the trade right there. But later on, when things, you know, progress, we can see that this is another entry, second entry first. You keep going out right there. You go another leg down. Huge another leg down first right there. Yep. So another setup we saw is more reliable, right? You remember auto block and fiberglass, the setup it have trend reversal. So we it less reliable on the breaker. The breaker is more reliable because the breaker, the market show you the hand already. So in this case, you know, the previous trade we can enter right here, right? Auto block, fiber gap, retest. But in this case, we have a better opportunity. This is a bearish breaker right here. And then it's retest this bearish breaker. And entry time for us is 13:12, which is perfect right there. A time of day perfect for entry right there. See? And the target gonna be the same. Later on we find out that this is first target. Second target we very deep down there near the new week opening gap right there first. Yeah, so that basically another two trade that we can check right there. Actually it's one trade, right? You either enter right here or you enter right here, the second entry, or you add more side and then just the rest is the history right there. So we have, this is the trade we take, right? We take the trade for this retracement, right? The temporary retracement. And this is a short trade for a very clean move or low resistance liquidity run right there. All right, before we wrap it up for today, I want to point out something real quick, very interesting in terms of the how the liquidity will run or how the hour will run. I want to point out on the 4 hour time frame. All right, let's delete this for now. Where is my 4 hour? Okay, right here. So, I mean, look at this the chart. What do we see? We see the huge Dow close candle right there at, you know, 4 hour time frame. And I call this X4 13, right? Because when you look at the daily, you don't see that. But when you look at the more detail, you can see this breakdown two candle, right? One candle start 9, and this candle start 13 for 4 hour time frame. You see it's huge Dow close candle. Then the next question for us is, how does this compare to other 4 hour time frame? We want to see the average, right? So average for the 4 hour time frame start at 13. Time frame, the average high and low is $4.1, and the average for open and close is $2. But this guy, let's see how big is this guy. Let's turn on. I want to turn it on. You see, so for this guy, it's $7. So it's almost twice of the average swing for the high and low. You see right there? And let me, we forgot to add the number for the open and close. I will try to add later, but we can use it to see what's the open and close way here. It's $5, so it's almost twice at open and close, the same, so the same ratio right there. So basically the high and low is twice at most at average, and open and close also twice at most as average. There's something going on right there. And we base this on the data set of 360 day, it was a year of data right there. I wish that I can add more data sets to see how this number, you know, how this number scale up, because the more data, the better your statistics is gonna be accurate. But in Thinker or Swim, you know, for intraday data sets, that don't allow you to go more than 30 days, because that's too much aggregation for the application to run. So that reason why they don't give much at all. So I do the maximum is 360 day right there, which is around 1 year, right? 1 day, 250 day. So yeah, around 1 year. 365 day. Yeah, it's around 1 year. Okay, so that is our wrap up for today, and let's see how tomorrow play out. One of scenario we can see right here that it haven't take out a buy seller greedy from this candle on last Thursday, right? So then the next day, Friday, maybe it's go up here, right? It retest this either this right here, this bearish breaker, or at least, you know, retest this, we fell look up right there, and it can come down to take this society. So that's another scenario for us right there. Or it even come down, you know, right here to retest this bearish, you know, bullish breaker right here also. That's the scenario that we anticipate for tomorrow. And also is the big move down. I don't think this move down is finished. Normally, not normally, but it's through, you know, our observation as experience, it will be another leg down to finish the down move. Because I believe too much liquidity down here, the sales of liquidity too much. And then it will need to go and wrap it. That's how the algorithm is built, right? It builds on the principle that it will maximize transaction. Basically, it wants people to buy and sell so it can make money, right? Because this is the middleman, right? The stock is standing, the middleman. It will make money when from the buy and the sell also, because when you participate in the stock market, which is an auction, you have to pay the fee. Both the sell and the buy had to pay the fee when they do the transaction. So the algorithm to run the stock exchange, it have to maximize the transaction so it can, you know, make more money. I think that's it for now, and thank you, and see you tomorrow. Bye for now.